हेलो ऑल माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर सेफ एट होम। आई विश यू ऑल द बेस्ट फॉर योर फ्यूचर सेफ्टी। सो हियर बेटा, लेट अस कम टू अ वन ऑफ द टॉपिक ऑफ चैप्टर वन फ्रॉम द यूनिट सेकेंड, दैट इज द लंचियन। सो हियर यू कैन सी ऑन माय स्क्रीन, दिस चैप्टर इज अबाउट नरेटर्स मीटिंग विद अ लेडी एट Foyot's restaurant, a very expensive, who is great fan of the narrator. Means Foyot hotel, or you can say that restaurant where senators of France, they used to do the lunch over there. And here luncheon, the title of the topic indicates Foyot's restaurant. Dinner party was very critical for the narrator. He was not capable, but he accepted unexpected situation at Foyot's restaurant meeting with lady. So this is about beta, it's a great challenge for the narrator, where he is just like an ordinary person. He's living, his lifestyle is very different, very simple. And and that he accepted one of the great challenge with the lady. He means who want to meet with him, and the place was fixed at the Foyot Hotel that was very expensive. So let us come to the chapter. And first, before the chapter, you consider the word meanings, various word meanings given. So you just consider each and every. Tried my level best to give all the word meaning hard words from this chapter. So after this word meaning, let us come to the chapter here. So beta, you come to know the luncheon. Luncheon means it's just like a dinner party. Suppose your family arranged a dinner party at any place, so what kind of situation will be there? So you can aware about this thing. And second thing beta, this is the crucial why this topic is title given as a luncheon, because it's a big challenge for the narrator. So let us come to know about that. I saw her in the theater. Who? That lady. I sat down beside her during the interval. It was long since I had last seen her. She addressed me brightly. This is the first meeting with the narrator. You can see on the image and where she was seated there, and you can see what kind of situation arise. And after all, you can see that here Kim's writer was seated, and this is the first meeting for long period. Okay, she was the great fan of writer. Okay, no doubt writer Somerset, he was a short story writer. And well, it is many years since we first met. Means so many long, after a long period they met with each other. Okay, do you remember the first time I saw you? And this is you asked me to luncheon. Who say this word spoken by lady? And you asked me to luncheon. Okay, it was 20 years ago. Matlab, the 20 years has been passed, and I was living in Paris. And that time I had a small apartment in a Latin quarter, and I was earning only just enough money to keep body and soul together. What is that? This keep bodies and soul together. It means writer was earning very simple. Means it's the one day is enough for the means it is surviving process for 1 month. It's enough for him to only the survival process. Okay, with the body and soul together. Not he is not earning more and more. Okay, she had read a book of mine. Okay, and had written to me about it. Okay, then presently I received from her another letter, saying that she was passing through Paris and would like to have a chat with me. Would I give her a little luncheon at Fiord's? Means that is the whose observation, right? Narrator's observation. कि मीन्स लेट अस प्रोसीड हर टू अ फेयोर्स रेस्टोरेंट. फेयोर्ड रेस्टोरेंट एज आई टोल्ड यू बेटा इन इंट्रोडक्शन, फेयोर्ड रेस्टोरेंट इज अ वेरी एक्सपेंसिव रेस्टोरेंट एट फ्रांस. ओके, सो देयर सीनेटर्स मीन्स पॉलिटिशियन यूज टू गो देयर. ओके, एंड दिस इज वॉट कि सच अ बिग होटल and such a big party, it was very very challengeable to the narrator, but he was thinking before. Then after that, Fjords is a restaurant at which the French senators, as I told, French senators mean French politicians, okay, eat, and it was so far beyond my means. First he was thinking let us proceed there, but then he come to know that it's beyond my capacity, I can't affordable that restaurant. Okay, so I had never even thought of going there. I can't think there. Okay, I have to go for your restaurant. Okay, I was flattered. Flattered means that is the praise. That is that he feel proud. Okay, and was too young to have learned to say no to a woman. I never say no. Okay, if the party arranged, okay, it's all right, I will accept, no problem. If who was thinking? The narrator was thinking. Okay, so I had 80 francs, gold franc. It's a money, it's a kind of money. French people use money, coin in a part of francs. It's known as francs. Okay, to last me the rest of the month. Means this month was enough for this 80 francs. Only this much, and a decent luncheon should miss here. What happened? Means he was first. What he decide? He decide to miss. Let us complete with this one because he is a very less money, and it shows that means writer was a very ordinary person. Okay, so after that, to last me the rest of the month, and a decent lunch should not cost more than 15. Means he was just calculating his mind that 15 franc is enough for the lunch, and if I stopped drinking coffee and for the next 2 weeks I could manage well enough. And student, he was thinking about past, future and present at that time, because he was a very ordinary person. You know the example, if you arrange some arrangement for the party to your friends, if your friends belong to the high profile, so what you try to manage, okay, let us consider it in a short way, it means ki thoda saste ho jaye, aise ho jaye. So but it is same thing is going on with the narrator here. Okay, so she was not so young as I expected. When she appeared in front of narrator, so she was just 40 years of age. Okay, and before that narrator was thinking ki maybe she is very young. Okay, so now she gave me the impression of having more teeth than were necessary for any practical purpose. Means it's a kind of body language what she is going to present here. And she talked a lot about me. Means first introduction was very long, the process was very long. And here writer and that lady, they were talking with each other. I was startled. Startled means meaning is there, but excited by sudden surprise. When narrator saw her, that time he was startled. And when the menu was brought, menu has come, for the price were a good deal higher than I had expected. Whatever writer, his judgment was very good, and his judgment was real. He means prices were very high when the menu came in at the table. And that time, but she assured me I never ate anything for luncheon. Okay, so whatever may be there, I will manage. She told like this way. Okay, so after that, I never eat anything for luncheon, she said. So first time she had given the impression that okay, don't worry, little bit I'll take the some snacks or maybe some breakfast, but she has not pretended that means okay, no, I will not do lunch, I will not do that or this, okay, whatever may be. And oh, don't say that, I answered generously. Writer don't know what she will do next time. So generously means beta, it's a liberally. He was very excited on that time. And he said, no, my madam, it's okay, no problem. You order anything. Okay. And then, I never ate more than one thing. I think people ate far too much nowadays. Who say? And this is the statement, the lady's spoken. Okay. So, I never ate more than one thing. Only one thing is enough for me. I think people ate far too much nowadays. Means people are eating, you know, that usually it happened to everyone. It means we are eating, if delicious food is there, so we can take one more, two chapati, three chapati, or whatever may be there. It means maybe more and more our expectation become very high. Okay. So here, a little fish perhaps. Means that is the very small snacks she told first. And I wonder if they have any salmon. What is the meaning of salmon, beta? Salmon, that is the pink orange. Salmon is a kind of pink orange is there. So where you are going to know about that? It means first of all, such impression she has given that the writer was quite satisfied. Okay, ma'am, will not order so much. Okay, so I am okay, no problem. I will manage. But what happened? Well, it was not on the menu, but I asked the waiter if there was any. Okay, well, it was not on the menu. Whatever they expected, it was not on the menu. Then, okay, they asked the waiter if there was any. Yes, a beautiful salmon had just come in. First food item was salmon that has appeared. Okay, the waiter asked her if she would have something while it was being cooked. Waiter tell very frankly, ma'am, if you order anything and you will give us 5 to 10 minutes, I will serve to you. Okay, waiter was very ready because he become very happy to know that this customer is very, VIP customers are there, and let us praise them. So then they will order, it means highly, they order the highest. Okay, you know that better search the opportunity like this way. Okay, they also get the trip. Okay, so no, she answered, I never ate more than one thing. Same sentence repeated right now. Okay, unless you have a little caviar. But a caviar, the meaning is here, salted roe of large fish. It's a kind of very delicious food at French. That Foyot Hotel, it is very expensive. Means it was charge was very high. The price was very high. Caviar. My heart sank a little. Whose heart? Narrator's heart. The narrator can't imagine that madam has ordered such a delicious food. The how much the price of that dish was? He was just sank. Sank means what? It's a fall down. Means he become in complete depression. Now that time he was in depression. Okay. Now I knew I could not afford caviar. I know that. And that but asked the waiter to bring it anyway. And for myself, okay, I chose the cheapest dish, one of the menu, that was mutton chop. Mutton chop is what, beta? It's a kind of means chop cut from a body of animal. Okay. It is also a different kind of delicious. Okay, so madam order caviar and the narrator order the mutton chop. Okay, she said, I don't know how you can expect to work after eating heavy things like chop. Madam, she know very well about that thing. You miss ki mutton chop is the heavy dish, and you can order. You should order for different dishes, a very luxurious dish or maybe very light dish. Okay. Just madam has ordered for caviar. Okay, I don't believe in overloading my stomach. It's madam's belief. Okay, so she add the caviar and then the salmon. These two dish appear and third was the mutton chop. Okay, but I wondered what the bill would come to. Writer was thinking about the only bill. What what will be the payment? Okay, when my mutton chop arrived, she took me quite seriously to task. That is, task is what, beta? It's an attempted. मीन्स सी कम टू नो दैट कि वाई आई हैड ऑर्डर दिस मटन चॉप एंड वॉट काइंड ऑफ सी वॉज दैट टाइम सी वॉज फॉर इंस्टेंट सी वॉज लुकिंग वेरी ईगर्सली एंड देन आई सी यू आर इन हैबिट ऑफ ईटिंग अ हैवी लंच मीन्स हु से मैडम मैडम से मीन्स कि एज आई नो कि मीन्स दैट हैवी डिस यू वॉन्ट ओके सो वाई डोंट यू फॉलो माई एग्जाम्पल वॉट आई सेड बिफोर एंड दैट एंड जस्ट ईट वन थिंग आई एम श्योर यूड फील सो मच बेटर फॉर इट तो वॉट सी एडवाइज कि मीन्स यू हैव टू ऑर्डर फॉर मीन्स वॉट जस्ट ईट वन थिंग अगेन सी इज रिपीटेड द सेम थिंग एंड आई एम ओनली गोइंग टू ईट वन थिंग आई सेड द वेटर केम अगेन विद द मेन्यू बट सी एट वॉट फर्स्ट इज अ सैलमन एंड देन कैवियर इज देयर आफ्टर कैवियर सी सी ड्रिंक दैट काइंड ऑफ जूस यू कैन ऑरेंज जूस और मे बी ऑरेंज पिंक that is the college of Salomon okay so after that what happened here she waved now I am only going to eat one thing I said the waiter come again with the menu then waiter again come and then she waved him aside with an airy gesture what do you mean by this airy gesture beta it's a wave of hand she was just her body language was very different she was very excited Miss, she was curious to, okay, yes, I will. So, what happened when you go to the any hotel? So, if you are the guest, how you order, if someone is going to pay you, you order the very, very luxurious item, okay, ye bilao, wo bilao, ye bilao, that's all. When you pay for yourself, then how much you order, you can imagine, okay? So, the ma'am was in the same position. So, no, I never eat anything for luncheon, okay? So I never eat anything for luncheon means after this mutton chop I am going to stop here okay so just a bite I eat that more as an excuse of conversation for than anything else I couldn't possibly eat anything more unless they had some of those great asparagus means that is the kind of cooked vegetable it's another kind of dishes So what is beta? You can imagine. Ki madam was saying that I am taking the little bit. I'm not interested to take a heavy meal. I take the only one thing. But she ordered the caviar, then salmon, again then asparagus. That is the asparagus is the cooked vegetable. It's another kind of delicious food made at the hotel fire. Okay, so. What is this asparagus? It's a very amazing for the writer. Oh my God, what is happening with me? And I'm completely going down. Okay. So instead of that, what happened? You can see the image of the waiter and see the what kind of image of madam and see the writer's face, narrator's face. So how he look upset. You can imagine very well. Okay. So no. I never ate anything for luncheon. And after that, I ate that more as an excuse of conversation than anything. I could not possibly eat anything more unless they had some of those great means asparagus. Asparagus, again, narrator's mind stuck for a moment. Oh my God, what madam is going to order? It's such a big delicious item she ordered here. And the narrator become very upset. That time he was in complete depression. Ki how much she will eat now? And she is telling that I will eat only one thing. And now again and again she is going to order miss today what happened to me. You can know that. Ki aapke bhi aise guest agar aage aur is tarah se wo phir to aapko sochna padega ki next time ko bulao ki nahi. So this happened to him. My heart sank as they were horribly expensive. And what items he caviar, salmon, then asparagus and these three items stuck the mind of the writer. I mean, narrator was completely disturbed at this time. Okay, madam, want to know if you had anything of those great asparagus? Means, if anything, he had given the option. Okay, maybe some other item. Okay, I asked the waiter. Who? Writer, narrator asked the waiter. Madam wants to know if you had any of those great asparagus. Miss Asparagus ke miss it's a any option will be there. So I tried with all my might to will him to say no. Means what writer want? Writer want let's ma'am will say no, but unfortunately madam say yes, I want only asparagus, means nothing else, because she like her very well. Okay, she like that item. Okay, so I am not in least hungry. My guest sigh, means my guest take a deep breath, means that time deep breath lena, and then after that what happened? But if you insist, I don't mind having some asparagus. I ordered them, no problem, koi baat nahi. Then ultimately finally what happened? Narrator ordered the asparagus. Okay, so aren't you going to have any? No, I never ate asparagus. I said panic seized me. Panic seized means writer was surrounded by the sorrowness. Writer was surrounded by the all kind of frustration, and it was not a question how much money I should have left over for the rest of the month. He was thinking about the month, how this month I will how I will survive myself, and he was thinking about the whole month. Okay, and but whether I had enough to pay the bill, he have a great dilemma, and he was a great dilemma that whether I will pay the this amount or not. He maybe some other example, let us accept the challenge. It's a big question for the writer's mind, and writer was thinking. He was not paid attention what ma'am is doing. He was in the hotel, but the crucial period was going on for the writer. Okay, so after that it would be mortifying. What is the mortifying? But it's a shameless, means it's a shameful, means it's a kind of word is given, shameful. Whether the mortifying means shameful, he means you have no money, and you just you had given the invitation to a guest to come at your hotel, or you had taken the dinner party and you have no money. So what kind of situation? No more enough money to satisfy your guest. So what happened with you? You always feel shame for you. So this is what the writer feel that it would be mortifying. Mortifying means shameful. And to find myself 10 francs short and be obliged to borrow from my guest. See beta, what is the, it's the same for anyone. If suppose their guest will come, and if the menu came and they had completed their dinner after that, and if the money is going to be short, and you will ask guest, okay, give me some money, I'll give you later on. So means it's a different kind of thing, na? It's a it feel that he means how cheap you are. It's look like that. So writer was feeling all these things, but the situation become very different, very horrible to the writer. A writer become very very upset right now, and be obliged to borrow from my guest. I could not bring myself to do that. I knew exactly how much I had, and if the bill come to more, and then what happened? I made a decision. If the jitna unke paas paise the, agar usse zyada bill aaya, to what I will do? I made a decision that I would put my hand in my pocket, okay, and with a dramatic cry say, means what? Say it had been stolen. My purse had been stolen by someone else. I pretend like this way, but I can't say that, okay, I have no money. Okay, so such kinds of things is going on writer's mind, and writer was completely, means he was in, means many negative thoughts has come. Okay, so after that then what happened? And it is here stolen. Of course it would be unfortunate if she had not money enough either to pay the bill. Then the only thing would be to leave my watch and say I would come back and pay later. So this is the thing has happened. He was thinking very low, okay, I will keep my watch to the hotel master if this kind of situation will arise. So what kind of miss, you can imagine that how writer was upset in this time. And then okay, so here it means the asparagus appeared. means that delicious item. You can see the image, beta. What kind of asparagus is there? It's a cooked vegetable. It's a one of the delicious food item. You can see the image. So here that has come. Okay. So they were big, delicious, and appetizing. Appetizing means it's a tasty, very delicious and tasty item appeared. I washed the shameless woman thirst asparagus down her throat, and the smell of melted butter hit my nose. Melted butter means the butter was just overspread over there, and it was melting means it's a form of liquid. Okay, so at last she finished. Oh, that, thank God she finished. And coffee, and what happened? At last she finished coffee. I said, yes, just an ice cream and coffee. See how the mister and narrator was saying that, okay, coffee, and see what's the excuse here? No, coffee with ice cream. Okay, so after that what happened? Then now ice cream, and then what happened there? Myself ice cream, yes, just then an ice cream and coffee, she answered. I was past caring now, so I ordered coffee for myself and an ice cream and coffee for her. Are you still hungry? Miss, I asked weakly. Miss, writer was, you know that, writer was completely upset, and he was asking that, ma'am, if you're hungry, to you let us order other thing also. He means you feel your stomach. Okay, so, oh no, I'm not in the, okay, I'm not hungry. You see, I don't eat luncheon. Means I had not done luncheon, and I have a cup of coffee in the morning and then dinner, but I never ate more than, means what is that? He means she accepted there. He means ki, you see, I don't eat luncheon. I have a cup of coffee in the morning and then dinner, but I never ate more than one thing for a luncheon. Again, she has repeated fourth time ki, same thing, ki, only one thing I always do in the morning. Okay, so here what happened? Then a terrible thing happened. What happened? While we were waiting for the coffee, and then the head waiter with a pleasant smile on his false face came up to us bearing a large basket full of big peaches. But before the coffee and ice cream, one more delicious item came. What is that? Means that is the full of big peaches. What is the peaches, beta? Peaches is the word that means the juicy fruit. Okay, after such a 3-4 item, then another last item, it's a desire, means wish of waiter. Now waiter become very happy that such a Miss VIP customer has come, and in the same way he was happy that because he will find a good profit, and he will find a trip. मतलब हम भी जाते हैं होटल में, तो वी वीज टू प्रोवाइड द ट्रिप टू अ वेटर व्हाट द सर्विस ही हैज डन बिफोर. ओके, सो वेटर वाज हैप्पी एंड ही ब्रॉट द बिग पीचेस दैट वाज द काइंड ऑफ जूस. एंड आफ्टर दैट मीन्स दे वर ब्यूटिफुल. दे हैड द रिच टोन ऑफ इटालियन कंट्री, बट श्योरली पीचेस वर नॉट इन द सीजन. That peaches were not season nahi tha unka, but it has come. So God knew what they cost. Oh my God, now it's a big problem for the narrator. What cost will be there? And then you see, you have filled your stomach with a lot of meat. My one miserable little chop. Miss writer thinks, miss, I had eaten only the mutton chop. But that lady, asparagus, salmon, caviar, then after that this fruity juice, and then last an ice cream. So she ate many more thing right now. And so I had taken one in the mutton chop. And so after that, you can't eat anymore. But I have just had a snack, and I shall enjoy a peach. The bill came. When I paid it, I found that I had only enough for a quite inadequate trip. inadequate trip, मतलब trip means you know that what we give to the better. Inadequate means incapable, unsatisfactory. Whether I used to pay the little money, but it's a question of prestige. When the question of prestige there, आपके पास 100 रुपये हैं तो आप सोचोगे नो 10 रुपीज़ 20 रुपीज़ से काम चल जाएगा, बट नो, वेन यू गो टू द बिग रेस्टोरेंट यू हैव टू पे मोर देन 50 or 100 मे बी देयर द सेम द क्वेश्चन अराइज ऑफ द प्रेस्टीज. ओके, सो हार्डली वॉट हाउ मच ही पेड. हर आईज रेस्टेड फॉर एन इंस्टेंट ऑन द मीन्स ओके द बिल. ओके, सो हर आईज रेस्टेड फॉर एन इंस्टेंट ऑन द 3 franc I left to for the waiter, only 3 francs. So she was not, she noticed for some time, but she was not thinking that writer's financial condition is not good, and so she has avoided on that time. Okay, so what happened? But when I walked out of the restaurant, I had the whole month before me and not a penny in my pocket. Means whole month will be, means writer will suffer. Only writer know this. And they came out from the restaurant. Because now the meeting is over, dinner party over. Now they came back and writer was thinking that this whole month I will suffer. This party is very, very remarkable incident for me. It's a very horrible party, he know it very well. And that what happened? After that, follow my example. She said, we shook hands. Miss and after it's the last meeting and never ate more than one thing for luncheon. Again she was repeating the same sentence. I will do better than that, I answered. Writer feel proud of himself ki usse maine acha hi kiya. Then what happened? I will eat nothing for dinner tonight. Humorist means it's a amusing person. It's a new, in a second way we can say that someone who acts. Miss madam feel with joy. Miss she is not in not having a serious mood and she was enjoying and laughing. Oh, you are Miss humorist. Miss she cried happily and jumping into the cab. She was happy that he what a good atmosphere and what kind of delicious party arranged, and she was happy on that time. And she was joyfully, she said, what is Miss, you are a humorist? Miss, what is that? You are quite a humorist. But I have had my revenge at last. Means, I have a revenge my last. Means, it's a not a kind of revenge seriously. But what thing is that? Means, he accepted the challenge. Who? Writer here. Okay? I do not believe that I am a vindictive. What is the vindictive meaning, beta? It's a seeking revenge. Okay, let us suppose madam has came there and such kind of revenge is that Miss writer was unsatisfied, but arrangement was very different, everything was just unexpected things were going on in front of writer. So this is the kind of revenge writer said. And after that, beta, but is when the immortal god take a hand in the matter, it is pardonable. What is the pardonable, beta? It's a forgivable. And forgivable means when the god take the matter, so it everything become easy. To observe the result with complacency. What is the complacency? That is the word, that is the satisfaction. If we think and while being indifferent. Means writer was satisfied when he learned, when he come to know that God will give the take a hand in the matter of it. And what happened today? She weighs 136 kilograms. What is the weightage of that lady? That is 136 kg. So means it's a big challenge for the writer. That the writer said that she is telling that I will eat only one thing and she is eating more than 1, 2 or 3, and let us see what happened to her. And ultimately see what the feedback is there, and finally result was there, she was 136 is the weight for her. Clear? So I hope that everybody understood this chapter. Better go through the word meaning carefully, and you will, once you read the chapter, and then in second video I will discuss with the question answer. Okay, thank you and have a nice day. Okay.